and rope trick. Eventually, they came back and tossed properly, much to the amusement of the big crowd present. And Chav and me and Dad won the toss and decided to bat. We're going to pick up play now in the very first over. Kapil Dev is the bowler. Madhusudan Azhar is batting. No runs on the board. And here's Ian Chappell.
And Madhusudan off the mark with a single to find lead.
Chetan Sharma to Mohsin Khan.
That's well run. Madhusudan very quick to call his partner through. And Mohsin is off the mark. And a bouncer there from Kapil Dev. It's a no ball. And Madhusudan has played it over the top of point. He played the shot on purpose in the air. And he's picked up three runs. It's a very big ground, the MCG. A lot of open spaces in the outfield. In the air and taken by Azharuddin. The ball just had a bit of a look out. But he's hung on to it. And Kapil Dev has struck as India continue their trend of getting an early wicket in these matches.
And that could not have been simpler, as Mohsin got this half volley on about the leg stump, swinging down the leg side. He clipped it very nicely, very sweetly off his toes, but unfortunately his weight falling away to the offside, lofted it and hit it straight into Azharuddin's hands. Mohsin Khan out for 5, 1 for 70. Ravi Rajah scored 60 against West Indies the other night. He was caught and bowled by Harper. 75 that he scored was notched against New Zealand in the recent tour of that country.
Well, India will hope that the young man survives to bowl his leg spinners pretty well. He's picked on a big man. Ray Isherwood is a good 6'3". Seaver is certainly at a weight disadvantage.
Laxman coming in, and my word, he was a little bit lax there too.
Kapil Dev. Two things going for the winners in this World Championship of Cricket final. First is the prestige. India trying to follow on from their World Cup victory in 1983 over West Indies. And then there's the financial side of it, 32,000 Australian dollars. It's the equivalent of around ₹500,000. And that, of course, depends on the currency rate at the time, but it's around about that figure. So from that point of view, apart from the pride, it's a very important game for these two teams. Take two there. Ravi Shastri down at deep third man. He's been one of the stars of this World Championship of Cricket. A very talented cricketer.
Chance for run out.
Quick. Well done. Good cricket. Good cricket from the fielder. Amanath, the wicketkeeper Vishwanath, who thought he had him, thought Ramiz Raja was gone. And in the end, good cricket from Ramiz Raja, who hurled himself at the crease.
Throw was too high. Well picked up by Amanath. The throw just was a fraction high. Had to be dragged down onto the stumps. The batsman makes his ground. Good running. Desperation from Raja. Good try. Good appeal.
And he's gone, caught behind, and it must have been called a wide, I should think, if he hadn't thrown the bat at it. Pakistan two down, and that was a needless wicket loss.
certainly was. It swung away a bit. See, it's very wide, and Bassett goes after it. This one half goes across and takes a straightforward catch. The vital breakthrough for India. They're on top in the early stage of this final. They're 2 for 29.
Lead to some dismay in Pakistan at that, but a lot of joy in India. Oh, knocked him over. First cherry, a great Yorker. Kasim Omar, who played so well in the defeat of the West Indies the other evening, has gone without scoring, and India are right on top.
Sheer pace, swinging Yorker, new batsman. Beautiful line, pitched about middle leg, swung in a bit, hitting across the line, took off stump. Beautiful piece of bowling by Kapil Dev. He's on a hat-trick, Pakistan reeling. As Omar departs without scoring. And what a buzz around the Melbourne cricket ground. 3 for 29. Jab at me and Dad, as Kapil Dev comes in from the southern end.
What a good ball. And the batsman a bit of a shock there. Nicely placed, and it'll go for four. It'll get onto those practice pitches down there and race away from the fielder. Glorious stroke from Javed Leander. Perfect reply to the loss of three quick wickets. Kapil Dev has the lot. Ramesh Raja has been watching in slightly bemused fashion after the fall of the first wicket, Mohsin Khan. He's still there. Ramesh Raja is batting in the white cap, Javed Miandad in the blue. Got him. He's waited for the decision, but he's going now. Ramesh Raja brilliantly caught. Magnificent catch by Srikanth just behind square. Mohammad Azharuddin was fielding in that area. Srikanth has gone there now and pulled off a brilliant catch that has the Pakistan team rocking.
Timed that beautifully, but didn't keep it down and flew to backward square leg. It was an inch above the ground. Just carried and caught it as clean as a whistle. And what a performance by the Indians, catching everything. Supremely confident, and he was a key man. Raja departs, and now Pakistan, 4 for 33.
Imran Khan, 32 years old, one of the great all-rounders in the world today. He was out at a crucial moment for Pakistan and their fortunes. Imran Khan's not moving, Vishwanath is. He's racing up. And Imran Khan just wasn't interested, nor was umpire Ray Isherwood.
Well, I don't know why, because it looked out to me, umpire Ray Isherwood standing in this final, went for the hook shot, sounded like a glove or something. It looked out, let's watch this closely. Oh, the big deflection. I'd say that was an umpiring mistake. As Vishwanath, the bowler, all the fieldsmen go up. Imran Khan stands his ground in a controversial moment. In the World Championship of Cricket, the MCG. In the one-day game where Australia hasn't been a participant, the record crowd previously was 30,196, West Indies versus England. In 1980, I'm sure this crowd today will be well past 30,000.
Yes, it'll be rather interesting if that Australian record, and I emphasise it is an Australian record, is broken today, that attendance 30,196, the previous best, a match at international level not involving Australia. Safely away past the left hand of the man at cover point, Sivaramakrishnan.
Madan Lal to Imran. Sit that straight down the ground. Beautiful shot by Imran. Straight drive. It was in the air, but he hit it very firmly. And it was four from the moment it left the bat. Wouldn't have shied at the stumps down there. Hits them. Question asked. It must have been pretty close, but Imran very quick. Let's have another look at that. See if Imran had got himself in.
He's a little slow moving, but had that bat grounded and made it comfortably there.
If there's any big hitting to be done, Imran will probably be the man expected to do it. And here, they'll be looking for two. And that's a good indication of the way these two play.
Amarnath to Shavit Miandad.
Oh, good delivery. An appeal from the keeper, Vishwanath. But I think he might be overdoing the appealing a little bit in memory of what happened with Imran earlier.
No emotion at all from the bowler, and Vishwanath gave it the big shout, but that didn't appear to be a catch. We have a good wicket on replay. A little bit of noise there. Umpire Ishwood not moved, but certainly there was a noise. Still a defensive offside field of three in the circle. Point, cover and mid-off, very square.
Late cut there from Javed, a shot that he plays particularly well. He's coming back for the second, and that is good running. Shastri is no slouch in the field at all.
Almost cut that ball out of Vishwanath's gloves. He played it very late and fine. Run rate's not high, it's 2.52, but they've stopped the four wickets. They've consolidated the situation slightly for Pakistan. You must bat through the 50 overs. That's the first criteria when you lose early wickets.
There's the pull shot, bouncing just in front of Azharuddin. He's got a very awkward bounce on that rough pitch area. Good return from Ben Sarkar, but once again the running is good.
Running was excellent. In fact, Imran could have been in trouble, except that ball didn't carry on the fall, and once it hit the turf it slowed down, but it was aggressive running from the start.
That's a beautiful stroke. The way over cover.
Imran Khan starting to cut loose. Pakistan supporters can breathe again for a moment anyway. A glorious stroke there from Imran Khan, and plenty of food for thought for Sunil Gavaskar. Safely away, although a rather thickish outside edge. They'll get three there. Javed will come back very quickly.
From an Indian point of view, it's going to be very interesting to see when Sunil Gavaskar brings into the attack Laxman Sivaran Krishman.
That's one of the penalties of standing up over the stumps.
Yes, he's been very aggressive with his keeping. Interesting bounce there. I've got the feeling there may have been some bat on that. Bounced way over the top of the shoulder. Couldn't pick anything up there.
Between two very grim-faced cricketers, they know there's still a lot of work to be done. 31 to Shavit, 35 to Imran Khan. This is the 34th over.
And there's going to be a change now to the attack, and this will be very interesting. Laxman Sivaramakrishnan being brought into the attack. He's the sixth bowler used by the Indians.
One.
Trouble. Stumps out. Imran Khan gone. Tragedy there as far as the Pakistanis are concerned. Imran Khan and Shavit Miandad, a misunderstanding. Imran looking for the single. And a lovely pick-up and throw.
Yes, there was no run here. Imran called for it. I don't think there was a run, and he had to go back very quickly. Direct hit there, and had they run, I reckon Javed would have been out. by 3 or 4 yards. So Imran calling, perhaps calling incorrectly. And that's a big blow for the Pakistanis. He's out for 35. And a lovely bit of fielding there by the Indian captain. Pakistan 5 for 101. Javed on 35. Salim hasn't been there long, just one. 35 overs gone. It's a full toss and hit away into the gap at square leg. It won't go for four. Mohammad Azhruddin moving around there from deep at wicket.
They'll take the single there off the pad. They're going to look for two. Two there, 5 for 113 in 36 overs. In 5 for 113, Javed 37, Salim Malik 7, Ravi Shastri to bowl. Here's Bill Laurie, and with him Frank Tyson.
Thank you, Richie, and a good sweep shot from Javed. That's 4 runs from the moment that left the bat. Beautifully played. Shastri being somewhere in about middle and leg stump, and he put it away.
Sivaramakrishnan to Salim Malik.
In the air, he's got him, he's dropped it straight to Shastri at cover. He played for that. It was a beautiful piece of bowling, and the wheels fell off there for Ravi Shastri. He should have caught that. It was a hard hit ball, but it was deep. He moved to it and put it down.
And this is what happens when you lean back on a drive such as that. It was just to the left of Ravi Shastri. He's normally the most reliable of fieldsmen.
This is the 39th over. They've got 5 wickets in hand. Their target possibly would be between 8 and 10 runs per over from here on into the 50th over. It's well played. He waited very late to cut that fine. Racing away towards the boundary. Amarnath Fields. 3 runs.
It's as though Sivaramakrishnan will not bowl out his 10 overs. Kapil Dev and Sharma still 6 overs to bowl between them.
It's in the air. There's a man out there. He's getting under it. Sharma's got it, has he? Yes, he has. Well caught. Sharma not making the same mistake that Ravi Shastri did at cover. Took a well-judged running catch, and the leg spinner strikes again.
And that's been fairly typical of the standard of out cricket played by India in this championship. It wasn't a very good stroke. Salim Malik has been hitting his drives in the air. He wasn't to the pitch of that. He lofted it to the long off position, and that was an exceptionally well-judged catch by Chetan Sharma. Again, moving around the boundary and getting right underneath it. He never looked like dropping it. 6 for 131.
Good hard-hitting batsman. He replaces Salim Malik. He'll hold out it deep long off to a good running catch by Sharma. Now the leg spinner comes into Javed as they crossed. Creech is gone, is he? It's a good effort. No, he's got him. What a good piece of bowling. An excellent leg break. Got him forward and spun a mile. Viswanath had the bails off. A brilliant piece of cricket.
And it looks as though India are going to bowl yet another side out with Sivaramakrishnan now on the hat-trick. That was a superb leg spinner to defeat a man of the caliber of Javed Miandad, who normally gets very close to the pitch of the ball, is a mighty feat. And the last hat-trick, indeed the only hat-trick to be performed in One Day Internationals, was by Jalaluddin for Pakistan against Australia in Hyderabad in 1982. So Miandad out for 48, 7 for 131.
Catch the batsman. It goes for the big hit. There's a man down there. He's getting under it. It's Amarnath. He doesn't get back in time. Dear, oh dear. It crashes into the fence. Could have been a hat trick. He was some 10 metres in from the fence. He hit it straight. What a courageous shot. The crowd's gone mad at the Melbourne Cricket Ground.
And that was an amazing piece of cricket. With Sivaramakrishnan there feeding up the wrong one. And the big hit on there.
And what a great over. Ever a man deserved a hat-trick, it was this over.
Yes, unfortunately, Gavaskar was too far in. looks as though he should have been on the fence.
And so he has gone the big hit against the wrong one and survived. This one's in the air, it clears the young lad's head. What an over.
Shastri to Tahir Nakash.
Got him! Yes, he's gone! Caught behind the ball that spun from the left arm up. Tahir trying to hit down the ground, picks up a wicket, and Pakistan in real trouble at 8 for 142.
And what a great pair of hands this little keeper has. Obviously Tahir in trouble, hitting against the spin. Went for the big hit over the top of mid-off. The ball turned slightly, caught the edge of the bat, and Vishwanath took it very wide on the offside. So Tahir Nakash out for 10, 8 for 142.
Anil Dalpat, the keeper, faces the leg spinner Siva Ramakrishnan.
Out! Yes, he's got another one. Beautifully bowled. He threw it up. He went the big hit through cover. Shastri this time didn't let the young lad down. And Pakistan reeling against spin here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground.
Again, that ball thrown up wide of the off stump. It was a wrong one. And it was smashed straight in the hands of Shastri at cover. So that's victim number 18 for the spinners, and Siva picks up another wicket. Anil Dalpat out without scoring.
Beautiful piece of bowling. He threw it up, he held it back. The batsman didn't get to the pitch of the ball. Well caught at cover. He's out for a duck, and it's 9 for 145.
Just two overs remaining. India bowled the West Indies out for 140 in that final of the World Cup. And I suppose Pakistan will have the advantage of bowling under lights. Oh, and they've got away with that. It wasn't a very good piece of running. Azim just haired off without telling Wasim Raja what he was doing. But they've got away with it. Pakistan with a run rate of 3.38. So Gavaskar is afforded that luxury with such a low run rate, and also the fact that he has a very skillful leg spinner. He's beaten not only the batsman, but the keeper. Fieldsmen coming from everywhere. And it's going to be Ravi Shastri who gets there first. So Siva has got five balls in which to take a wicket and give India the honour of bowling out the opposition five times. Ball hit. And one bounce over the fence. That's a good shot from Wasim Raja. Pakistan made 183 against India in the preliminary round match. And so, for the first time, India haven't bowled out the opposition. They've gone very close. 9 for 176 after 50 overs. And as I mentioned, Pakistan made 183 in their previous contest here at the...
It doesn't seem a very big total. It certainly won't seem a very big one to the Pakistanis, but it still has to be made by the Indians. I thought the Indians bowled really well out there, particularly Kapil Dev, and that's the reason for Pakistan having that scoreline of 9 for 176. At least they got up to get through their full 50 overs. At one stage, it looked as though they might well be bowled out for 40. Top score of Javed Miandad, 48. Imran Khan, 35. That was a good partnership, 68 in 22 overs, even though it took a little bit of time. Looked as though it was going to pull them round and give them a chance of getting 200 or 210. And the last wicket, the unbroken partnership, Wasim Raja and Asim Hafiz, 31 in just 8 overs. The bowling figures, Kapil Dev, magnificent. 9 overs, 1 maiden, 3 for 23. He moved the ball in the air and off the seam again. Chetan Sharma, 1 wicket, coming in to replace Roger Binney. Ravi Shastri, 1, bowled very tightly again for much of the time. And Siva Ramakrishnan, 3 for 35. So the Indians needed 177. At 3.54 per over, and we pick up play now in the second over. Azim Hafiz, the left-hander, is the bowler, bowling to Ravi Shastri, and your commentators Bill Laurie and Tony Greg.
And that one's hit past the mid-off and down towards the boundary. That fielded down there. Desperate stuff by the Pakistanis.
Saleem giving chase after that magnificent off-drive from Ravi Shastri. He went into it and he punched it straight. The left arm over the wicket bowler. The angle was there and he kept the elbow up and punched it straight down this big Melbourne cricket ground. Saleem desperate to cut off that run as he slides into the steel pickets and knocks it back. A brilliant piece of fielding.
This is his fifth over. He's bowled four prior to this and conceded only two runs, and so he's been very economical. But they're not up against many runs, and so they'll need to take some wickets early on, especially to put a little bit of extra pressure on the Indians. Well, that's hit in the air into the gap at mid-wicket. Once again, Kasim Omar, the fieldsman. One of the problems Jarvid now has is whether to perhaps keep him going for a little longer or to introduce someone else. Udasa has been the man who's picked up a fair few wickets for the Pakistanis. Won't be long, I shouldn't think, before he's brought into the attack. That's a lovely shot by Srikanth. Whipped away through the gap on the onside. Srikanth flying up and down the pitch there. Collect themselves three, five from that over. A good one for the Indians. No wicket for 14.
This now is the 10th over. And he's away. It's a beautiful stroke. Straight over the top. Nice way to break away.
Absolutely magnificent shot there from Srikanth. Really has been tied down. I think the plan has been to bowl short to him. And, well, I was going to say they made the mistake of pitching it up, but it wasn't a half volley. He's hit it on the rise and a good two or three rows back into bay 17.
Their rate was 3.54, now it's gone up to 3.92. All wickets standing. That's four runs. First time anyone has strayed in direction, and it's been costly for Tahir Nakash.
Pakistan not only need to tie India down, but they've got to get some wickets. They've contained the batsmen so far, but this very fine opening partnership of Srikanth and Shastri has held them at bay, and with India's long batting lineup, it's going to make their job a lot easier as the night goes on. Even if they are contained, they're always going to have plenty of batting in hand.
That was going to miss leg stump.
It's a very prolonged appeal there from Tahir, but the ball was going down leg side. And would have missed a leg stump by a few inches. Beautifully hit. Magnificent piece of timing. Tahir was looking for the Yorker. And just missed by a couple of inches, and it's costing four runs. Certainly is a magnificent timer of the ball when he gets them near the middle of the bat.
It's the site from one of the landmarks of the city. Beautifully illuminated. And an excellent seeing ground now. And Pakistan just struggling for the breakthrough here. Imran Khan and Azim Hafiz bowled very well. In their first nine overs, they allowed only 14 runs. But now they must break through. They've got to get through Srikanth or Shastri. Just wide of the fielder again. didn't quite get it, I don't think, but it's still raced away from Kazim Omar at mid-on.
Srikanth taking advantage of the fact that this is the last over where Javid is only allowed two men outside the circle. Really does like that ball when it's pitched up. And on that occasion, he just hit it wide of Kazim.
No wickets taken yet. As you can see there, Imran, the most economical by a long way. The Indians clearly content on seeing Imran off. And this will be interesting. Srikanth to face Wasim Raja. That's nicely played. Just a little short, that ball. And cut away just behind the square. Ravi Shastri's decided that he wants three. And that three brings up the 50 for the Indians. Well, that one kept a little low and was very well played by Ravi Shastri. Kazim Omar running into the fence, managing to get it back. That's good fielding by him too. Three runs from that shot. A good bit of fielding by Kazim, no wicket for.
Ravi Shastri, 22. Very poor strike rate. That off 61 balls. 31 to Srikanth, that's slightly better. Off 54 deliveries. And the support for the Indians mounting, the happy smiles on their faces there as they see all is going well for their side.
Well, it's going to be the leg spinners and top spinners and googlies again of Wasim Raja. That one once again cut away square. He's going to have to be a little careful of that shortish ball, which Srikanth liked them in that area. Well, that's down the ground. This could be out, or is it six? It's going over the top. It's six. Another six. That's the second one Srikanth's hit in that area. And the fieldsman down there has hurt himself. Ramiz is the man. He was trying to catch that and got himself bent over the railings down there. He's in trouble.
Yes, he's run into the top of the railings. He was going back to see if he could take that catch, keeping his eye on the ball, not realizing how close he was to the boundary. And as a result, there's something seriously wrong there. Something seriously wrong, because it looks as though he's jammed his chest on the top of the rails and looks as though he's having some trouble with his breathing.
That is it, straight down the ground. And notice how he goes backwards there, down towards those rails, perhaps not with his eye on him, and who could blame him for that, and then whack over the top. It was the rib cage area that would have taken a bit of a battering. That was hit high and hard down the ground. Actually a beautiful shot. And in his efforts to keep his eye on the ball, whack, he went into the little stubby things on the top of that fence down there. And anyhow, he's up on his feet. Oh, just stunned him, actually. I look as if they're going to lead him off down towards the dressing room, perhaps put an ice pack on that.
I think he got thoroughly alarmed then when, after having run into that fence, he probably had difficulty with his breathing.
...23 overs bowled, no wicket for 71. The only problem for India, their run rate's down a bit at this stage, but they have 10 wickets in hand. Very good batting lineup. The Melbourne cricket ground floodlit. Very warm and pleasant evening. Still in the high 20s. Good crowd in. And the pressure now on the Pakistani bowlers. Wasim Raja only hit that in the air. The man's getting under this one. He's got a chance. He's dropped it. It's gone over the fence for six. I believe that bounced out of his hands and went for six. He's called four. Let's have a look at that replay, because if that went over the fence, it was six. But Salim Malik has put down a well-hit ball.
Srikanth right to the pitch of the ball. For a moment, it looked as though it was going to be caught, the deflection, and into the fence. For a moment, Bill, it looked as though it
went over the top. Catch that should have been taken.
Well, it doesn't stop him from going down the ground and coming back for the second. He's a great runner between the wickets, Rakant. And what a part he's played this evening in this opening stand. That was a let-off that Pakistan could ill afford. It brings up his 50 and 64 deliveries. A great knock.
Two sixes and three fours in Rakant's 50, and a warm ovation for him from this MCG crowd.
Rakant front stroke. Cuts, beats the man at backward point. Racing away for four. My word, he's in good touch, Rakant. He's done a lot of damage throughout this series by playing his shots on both sides of the wicket. He sweeps, fine. Four more, beautifully played. Rakant sweeping beautifully. And that's the over. It's 91 for North. One ball remaining in this over from Imran. He's conceded three runs. It's Rakant on strike. He's hit it over mid-off. It's a great hit. It's going out towards the fence. One bounce. It stops short. Runs into the gutter. Seven off the over. Beautifully played. 98 without loss. India in the 27th over. Cuts. Gone. Caught at point. Well caught by Wasim Raja. It was short. Imran dropped it in. He slashed square. And Raja took a great catch.
That went sharply from the bat of Srikanth. It was short. He pinned the ears back. And that went like a rocket to Wasim Raja at backward point. Srikanth let off a couple of overs ago, but this was not to be another one. Good sharp chance taken by Wasim Raja. So Imran Khan picking up the wicket they needed, but is it too late? Srikanth out for 67 and India one for 103 in this 29th over.
No relation to Chaz and Dave. Well, that's a good delivery, but dropped. And it'll be a boundary. Del Pat, I think from memory, dropped Azharuddin in their preliminary round match, and that could well have been off Imran's bowling.
What a very good ball, though, this one was from Imran. Just moved slightly off the wicket and straight through the gloves. Unfortunately, Imran not at all impressed.
And, on the Yarra River, just across from the MCG, the fireworks are in progress.
If they're as good as those ones, I'll be worth watching. That's a good shot straight down the ground. And love Bert, I don't know where that came from, but it was a great shot anyway.
Attempted bouncer from Tahir, and that was a very well-timed shot by Azharuddin.
He really does time that ball beautifully. A lot of time, and then when he decides what shot to play, he really does put it in the right position. Beautiful.
In record for one-day matches, not involving Australia, 30,196. That was when the West Indies played England here at the MCG back in 1980. And the crowd today, there it is, a new record for matches not involving the Australians. 35,296. And he's bowled him.
Well, Azraddin trying to force that one back down the ground. And once again, Tahir Nakash nipping one back just a little, I'd say. And that was the end of Mohammad Azraddin.
Careless shot from the right-hander, but he's done his job. Coming in before Srikanth, just done enough. This evening, following his 93 not out against Pakistan in the first match, picked up another 25 this evening, and India 2 for 142.
And that's how it's all happened. 50 runs, the initial 50 off 106 balls. And then, as you can see, from then on in, things getting a little quicker and then slowing down again once Srikanth was out. That's it. It's his 50. He's played well in this World Championship of Cricket, and his fellow teammates there appreciating that too.
And the third consecutive 50 in this series for Ravi Shastri. 51 against Australia in the last match, in the lead-up matches. 53 in the semi-final, and now another 50. This one a slower one, but certainly a very important one from an Indian point of view.
He loves that shot. Anything on leg stump and just going down. Plays the glide away on the leg side very well. And indeed plays the shot through mid-wicket well too. Anything, in fact, on the leg side.
Being a tall man, no problem really to guide that ball off the hips. Really nice flick of the wrist by him, as Tony Gregg mentioned. Very strong off his legs and off his hips.
Hit that one over the top, down towards the boundary, a deep mid-wicket. Well, Ravi Shastri, I think, has sensed victory here. He's worked very hard for it. And he's decided now to open up a little.
And I would think that he would dearly like to smile, but not quite prepared to at the moment. The Indians coasting towards victory now. Shastri just taking the odd risk or two. Pull that one from right off stump.
12 runs required for victory as the signatures of the bats in the dressing rooms get signed belatedly. The Indians coasting to a great victory in the World Championship of Cricket. They've deserved it. They've been undefeated throughout the series. And now Imran coming back for the final onslaught. His first 8 overs. Cost him 21 runs for 1 wicket. Catch went down. He's saying, watch for the one. It's not over yet. This is the 45th over. It's over the infield. That's beautifully played by Gonsaka. Pick up the great fast bowler. They'll pick up 3. That breaks the shackles in this 9th over from the great Imran Khan. He's given his all tonight for Pakistan. Picked up a wicket for Cant. Had a chance dropped off Azraddin behind the stumps. Beats him. Could have been a catch. We'll watch for the umpire's call. Yes, it was. So poor old O'Neill, Delpat having a bad night. 2 catches, both have gone down.
Shastri venturing down the wicket. It's probably the last thing that Delpat thought he'd do is get an outside edge.
There it is, victory for India. Well played, a fantastic performance. Victory by 8 wickets. The batsman not out, Shastri 63, Gonsaka 17, and the huge crowd give them a standing ovation. A tremendous performance by Ravi Shastri, Philip Gonsaka. The stump from the umpire, and Keith, I believe everybody here at the ground and watching throughout the world would say, well played, India, as the fireworks begins.
Well, they really are a very good-looking side, the Indians. They've played wonderfully well throughout this championship, and tonight their batting was just as solid and good as was their fielding and bowling. Their final card of 2 for 177 from 47.1 overs meant that they won with 2.5 overs to spare. They had 8 wickets in hand, and it was a thoroughly comprehensive victory. Srikanth out for 67 in 78 balls faced. Mohammad Azharuddin 25 in 26. They played beautifully, some lovely strokes there. Ravi Shastri was more circumspect, 63 off 149 and unbeaten. And Vensarkar again gave us some glimpses of real batting culture. The partnership's a century stand for Shastri and Srikanth, 103 in 29 overs. A fine performance that to match some of the others they've put up in this World Championship of Cricket. For the Pakistan bowlers, I thought Imran Khan was outstanding. 10 overs, 3 maidens, 1 for 28, and very unlucky as well. The one or two expensive ones there, and Tahir Nakash took 1 for 35 in 10 overs. So a really good and sound victory, brilliant at times, by the Indians, and it matched their performance in the World Cup in 1983, where they beat the West Indies. We go down now to the presentation area for the handing over of the cheques for the winners, India, and the runners-up, Pakistan.
On behalf of the Benson Hedges Company, I'd like to thank the VCA and the ACB for arranging this superb tournament. All the teams, and in particular the two teams tonight, both the team who won and the team who lost. A great game of cricket, and also congratulations to all the people who came and supported them. Now I'd like to ask Sunil Gavaskar if he'll come up and accept a check for $32,000. And I'd also like to present the Benson Hedges World Championship of Cricket Trophy. Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I'd like to thank the manager and the members of my team for having given me this wonderful present on my last day as captain of India. I don't think I could have asked for a better gift than this superb trophy. And I'm truly thankful to the members, my colleagues, and the manager for having made it possible for me to finish my last day as captain on a winning note. I'd like to thank also the Victorian Cricket Association for having invited us, the Benson and Hedges Company for sponsoring this tournament. And before I end and before I forget, I'd like to wish Victorian Cricket Association and the people of Victoria a very happy, memorable 150th anniversary. Thank you all.
And a very happy birthday to you too, Sonny. He captained India magnificently in this competition. They thoroughly deserved their win, following on their victory in the World Cup of 1983 in England. And they all played very well, a very competent and sometimes brilliant-looking side. And what a change to come out here to Australia from India, where they'd been beaten in the Test series by England and lost the one-day international games as well. Well, Srikanth, the opening batsman, was named as player of the match here at the MCG. And the man who won the Audi car was Ravi Shastri for his all-round performances in this World Championship of Cricket. But it's been a pleasure to bring you the highlights on behalf of Nine's Wide World of Sports in Australia. And the only thing I can say is that the next time we meet, it will be when England play Australia for the Ashes. Unfortunately, neither of those sides got through even to the semi-finals of the World Championship of Cricket. Good night.
This has been another presentation from Nine's Wide World of Sports. The World Championship of Cricket telecasts presented by Sharp, Shell, Johnson & Johnson, British Banks, and National Mutual.